One day during a routine patrol in Afghanistan, something unexpected caught Staff Sergeant Mark Greiner's attention. He saw a group of kids dragging a puppy by the neck with a string.
You can't even call it a rope, it was so small. Anyway, and then she would sit her butt down and, you know, and then they'd throw rocks at her and everything, trying to get her going.
The soldiers bought the dog for a dollar and named her Callie, short for Caligouche, their base in Afghanistan.
Whenever we got attacked with mortars or rockets, you know, I'd put all my body armor on. She'd trot behind me.
Hiding out in bunkers and going out on missions. Callie wasn't just Mark's shadow. She became his solace in the middle of a war zone.
It keeps you human, feeling a little angry at the world. Here you got a puppy that just comes up and loves you.
Leaving her behind in Afghanistan meant certain death, and that was something he couldn't live with.
It was one of those pleas like, can I have a puppy, please?
And I'm thinking, this is the craziest thing we've ever done to even consider doing it.
Back in Grundy County, Mark's wife set out on a mission of her own to bring Callie home.
Sometimes when you don't know if they're coming back, you know, he loved her and, you know, it was part of him.
Rescuing the dogs in Afghanistan is only half the battle for the Iowa soldiers. Bringing them here means coming up with the thousands of dollars to cover expenses like room and board, shots, and the flight here.
If I didn't get Delta home, I would always be wondering what happened to her.
Specialist Sheila Schaefer remembers the first time she saw the beat-up mutt named Delta.
She had a collar embedded in her neck. She had blood all over the front of her, several wounds on her.
The wounded dog wasn't alone. She lived on base with seven puppies. They were affectionately known as Delta and Company. Sheila fed them MREs and protected them from the rifles of other soldiers. It was the highlight of her day.
And that was like something for us every day to look forward to and go out there and just hold these little puppies and cuddle them and love them and nurture them. I mean, in a war zone, that's like a big thing. It is. I get goosebumps thinking about it.
Back in Fairfield, the soldier has a hard time explaining the bond she formed in Afghanistan.
They don't understand it. They don't. Because a lot of the people here, the first thing they said to me was, we have all these dogs that don't have homes in America. Why are you going to do that with a dog from Afghanistan?
Only those who walked in our boots can truly understand.
That's the human side of us. That's what we're fighting for out there.
Sheila's fighting days are over, and so is the worrying about Delta's future. She came up with the money to bring the dog to the U.S., but Delta's puppies are still in Afghanistan. Each has a home waiting in Iowa, but their soldiers don't have the money to get them here.
Leave it to Sheila. She'll go to Afghanistan and bring a dog home with her, and sure enough, I did.
She's very strong.
So did Mark. He and Callie were reunited for the first time in 4 months.
She jumps up in my lap and just this little puppy yelp.
The family drained their savings to bring her from the mountains of Afghanistan to the plains of Iowa.
It was worth every penny.
This is something tangible that I know I made a difference. You're like wondering if you're doing any good. And you know, this is something right here. Got a puppy back home.
Go.
His shadow in Afghanistan is now part of his family in Iowa. Janae Town, Channel 13 News. Freedom.
She's very shy. She's like just really timid.
Liberty.
She's got to sniff everything.
And the lovable Charlie.
Oh, thank you.
And these guys appreciate the love that you give them, like more so than any dog. I mean, because they don't know, they've never had it.
They're part of Delta and Company, the war dogs Iowa soldiers rescued in Afghanistan. This week, they're seeing each other for the first time in 5 months.
Every single one of these dogs, I've had tears in my eyes seeing them because I took care of them and they were like my kids.
Sheila Schaefer protected Delta and her seven pups like they were her own. U.S. soldiers have standing orders to shoot stray cats and dogs on base, but it was an order she and her battle buddies couldn't follow.
Just being in a combat zone, it feels like I'm closer to the dog with friendship and family because we were out there together.
Penny Harold didn't know when she would see Liberty again, but the soldiers were on a mission to bring the puppies to Iowa. They went to work raising money for a cause few can understand.
I could sit here and talk to people, tell them blue in the face, and they would still have no idea what I'm talking about. They wouldn't know they wouldn't understand the feelings or anything. It'd have to be an experience to live through to understand.
They survived the war together, and the reunion takes Adam Reniker back to Afghanistan.
I can see myself, you know, doing tower guard right before dark. And how many people can say that they have a dog, you know, from their, you know, maybe their first deployment, second deployment, you know. Not too people can say they have an animal that was in the same environment that they were when they were overseas. So I think that's a huge difference between adopting a dog from over there or here.
But freedom isn't free.
Essentially a $4,000 dog, so.
It was donated by family, friends, and strangers. Adam expects his expensive mod will have an easier time adjusting than the soldiers did.
I don't think she knows how lucky she is, but I think once we get home, she gets a bath and gets her nails trimmed and gets on the couch, I think she'll start to realize how lucky she has it.
You can put Charlie up in the front.
One by one, the Iowa soldiers are welcoming the dogs they bonded with at war. But their mission isn't complete until all of Delta and Company returns.
We have two more puppies left in Afghanistan, and I will get them back here. And that's the day I'll feel relief, knowing that I didn't leave them behind and I kept my promise that I'd get them here.
To bring their battle buddies home. In Cedar Rapids, Janae Towne, Channel 13 News.